And they're here tonight on this excellent night of figure skating. Based on the short program on Saturday, it should be a wonderful competition tonight. Now Tiffany and Philip continuing with their Olympic debut.
Concerto number 3 by Prokofiev. They open with side-by-side triple toe loops.
All right.
She did beauty, he doubled.
I was watching her because she's been nursing a knee since the warm-up. She's been stretching it. It's like she might have gotten slightly injured in the warm-up, but getting that out of the way builds your confidence.
Side jumps and the throws that are always the most difficult. Here's the throw, triple toe loop.
Looked like it never really got off the ground. There wasn't a lot of pop to that triple toe.
He missed 4 months of training when Philip had a stress fracture in his left hip. In fact, he was on crutches as late as October of last year.
This is only their second competition this season, and when you miss that kind of time and that kind of training, under a pressure situation, you just don't have anything to fall back on.
They were second at the U.S. Nationals last month, their first competition. In fact, they've been second the last 3 times at the U.S. Nationals.
It's because this is one of the only pairs who rotates all their moves clockwise. Normally, all pairs rotate counterclockwise. And it's been very difficult for them in practice because on the ice with 4 other teams, you can imagine the risk of collision.
Everything they've been through injury-wise, it's a miracle they're here. I was talking to Dr. Malin Bradley, the team doctor today, and he said that she's the tough one, but she's been impressed by him because of everything he's been through just to get here.
Mm-hmm. from the U.S., Tiffany Scott and Philip Dulebohn. And the medal contenders beginning to arrive at the Salt Lake Ice Center. They'll be skating later. Jamie Salley and David Pelletier in the building.
Guys.
Back to the ice center for Scott and Dulebohn's marks in just a moment. Tiffany Scott, Philip Dulebohn awaiting their marks after their free skate at the Olympics. Nine judges, they submit two marks. First for technical merit. High of 5 and a low of 4-6.
The two throws really hurt them, the two falls, and those are really glaring things, especially when you're up against a strong field with huge throws.
They're also difficult falls to recover from.
So Scott and Dulebohn in their Olympic debut in Salt Lake City. And now, next on the ice, one of the young Chinese pairs. They're currently in 10th place, Pang Qing and Tong Jian. The Chinese traditionally known for their athleticism. Seems to be a buck charm around the neck, similar to the one that Michelle Kwan wears. Chinese good luck charm. Pang and Tong, the Chinese sending three teams to these Olympics, and one of them a chance for the gold medal later tonight.
Another piano concerto, this time number 2 by Rachmaninoff. This pair is the second-rated team in China, although they're behind the third pair here
tenth
in the short program.
10th place after the short.
Side-by-side double axles.
Right into triple toes. Step out, both partners step out. Especially watch this.
Gorgeous triple twist. And the Chinese throws are phenomenal. Throw triple sao cow. She fought for that.
There's never been any question about the throws. It's the artistic part. And this pair has worked in the off-season with a ballet instructor twice a week for 8 weeks.
Skating program is lack of spinning, quality of their spins, and they've always been criticized for the lack of artistry, but they've really addressed it. They've really put a lot of effort into having an improved line, speed, and carriage. And we'll get them that second mark. Thank you.
one more throw, the throw triple loop. Watch the boy this time. Oftentimes, the Chinese technique is to really throw the girl with such a thrust that they lose control, the boy loses control.
China, Pang Qing and Tong Jian. We'll return for their marks in just a moment. Meantime, the medal contenders continue to arrive. Anton Sikharulidze and Elena Berezhnaya trying to continue the Russian domination in pairs. They lead. Seem to be pleased with their marks. And now here's another Chinese pairs team, and the youngest one they had, just 17 years old, Zhang Dan and Zhang Hao. Despite the same last name, not related, but they've been working on a quad twist in practice.
And they have successfully landed it in competition. They had a fantastic night last night, standing ovation. They were in shock.
Perhaps the future for Torino.
They're the junior world champions. This is only their second senior competition. And here it comes. A quad twist.
It's a triple.
It was a triple.
Nice triple toe loops there.
Two nights ago when they received their standing ovation after the short program, it seemed like they didn't know how to react, whether to even smile.
Big, easy throw, triple south.
I think, Tom, that's something they'll learn pretty quickly.
The choreography in this program is still very basic. Yeah. It's very young. Developing, we say it's a developing pair.
It's very, as we say, a junior pair team.
17.
But that's where they are right now, and this is a fantastic experience for them.
Opened up on that triple sack, how he did his. This is their weakness, the spins.
The Chinese seem to be very intent on working on their weaknesses, though, their spins, their artistic aspects. And it's not beyond the realm of imagination to see in Torino in 4 years' time, these skaters being one of the favorites.
They're only going to get stronger.
When the Chinese first began to get into skating, the only way they could learn was from videotapes. And they went straight to the hard tricks, the throws and the lifts. And
probably their gymnastics background.
That's right. And what they never really did learn was basic skating skills, the quality of edges and the spins that we keep repeating. And that now is catching up with them. They've addressed the choreography, but I feel that they still have to address the fundamentals. Because when you do have problems like this, there's nothing to fall back on. You can't recover so quickly.
Singled hers and the double flips, and you can really see stamina is a problem. Every one of these teams has practiced so much faster, but with a full building, it's much, much warmer in here, and we are at altitude.
From China, a pair of 17-year-olds, Zhang Dan and Zhang Hao. Well, we're just getting warmed up at the Salt Lake Ice Center. Before the night is over, we'll be awarding gold, silver, and bronze. Much more to come. Jamie Salling, David Pelletier. The world champions from Canada may have the perfect mix of artistry and athleticism. Almost 4 years ago, they thought about ending their respective skating careers. Now they've found a magic together that may land them Olympic gold. Power is the calling card of the top pair from China. Tonight, Shen and Zhao have the opportunity to give China their first ever Winter Olympic gold and perhaps make Olympic history with a quad throw. A figure skating pair from the Soviet Union or Russia has won the gold medal in the last 10 Olympics. Now, star-crossed partners from St. Petersburg carry the burden of that legacy. Can their majestic grace keep the streak alive? Three pairs, one gold. It all happens tonight. Welcome back to the Salt Lake Ice Center. Backstage, Jamie Salley, the Canadian skater who, along with her partner, is in second place as we come to tonight's pairs free skate. She and David Pelletier hoping to break the Russian stranglehold on pair skating. In fact, there are the last non-Soviet or Russian skaters to win the gold medal. 1960 at Squaw Valley, skating outdoors on the outdoor rink, Barbara Wagner and Robert Paul from Canada were the last In fact, here is the domination by Soviets and Russians. The last 10 Olympic Games. The last time a non-Russian won pairs, when Barbara Wagner and Robert Paul won, Dwight Eisenhower was the president. In fact, his vice president, Richard Nixon, opened the games at Squaw Valley, and later that year would be defeated in the general election by John F. Kennedy. Anton Sikharulidze of Russia, the heir to that great domination, the largest in all the Winter Games, is in first place as we come to the free skate. And earlier this week, up in Logan, Utah, where they had been training, Elena and Anton stuck their hands in cement for posterity. Detente has come a long way.
Cool.
And taking their warm-ups now, the penultimate warm-up group, the American champions, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, hoping that they would finish in the top four to skate in the final group. They just missed it by one place in fifth place. Technically still alive for a medal, but it would be a long shot.
Mathematically still in it, but they're going to need a little help from the teams in front of them.
What, the way we've been looking at this competition, first place seems to be absolutely between the first and second team, the Russians and the Canadians. Whoever skates the cleanest with the most magic will probably win. But if either of them make any kind of mistake, the Chinese are in there.
It all plays out later tonight, live from the Salt Lake Ice Center. Here's tonight's Salt Lake Ice Center. The three-time U.S. champions, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, in fifth place entering tonight's free skate, and a chance to win a medal. In fact, the last Olympic pairs medal for the United States, 1988. Jill Watson and Peter Oppegaard. Kyoko and John hope to get that bronze medal. We said it's a long shot, but it is a shot.
Well, the only thing that's really upsetting about them going first in this warm-up group is you want to, A, be as close to those top pairs as possible so you're easily compared to them. And then when you're first out of the warm-up, you lose some of the warm-up because you have to recover a little bit to get ready for your program, because stamina is a huge issue.
Tamara Moskvina is their coach, the Russian coach of the U.S. pair. She also coaches the pairs team leading at the moment from Russia, Berezhnaya and Sikharulidze. So doing double duty tonight, the legendary Tamara Moskvina. Kyoko, born in Tokyo, grew up in New York City. John from Birmingham, Alabama, though he moved around a lot. And the crowd starting to get behind the Americans.
They have to be clean. That's all there is to it.
They have to be clean, and the two pairs ahead of them have to make some serious mistakes. That would be the second Russian team and the Chinese.
Their skating has really picked up since they started communicating at a weekly lunch when they talk about anything, and they come up with their quote of the week. Their quote for the Olympics: have fun.
They were so moved by the audience reaction last night, two nights ago.
Well, they've been having fun, but it would be a lot more fun if they could get a medal.
Trouble with his consistency on jump, side-by-side, triple toe loop. Yes. Beautiful.
That's the best one he's done all week. Double axles. Yes. Triple twist.
a throw, triple loop, anything you do before a throw makes it more difficult.
Yes. That was sheer will and determination.
Lots of original moves. Artur Dmitriev helped choreograph it, the two-time Olympic champion. Is incredible. His foot position here, spread eagle, is so high risk. One small mistake and they're gone.
Triple south row.
Ovation at the Salt Lake Ice Center, and that big smile on Kyoko's face pretty much sums up their performance.
Fantastic!
Now it's a waiting game.
The marks. We'll have them when we come back. Salt Lake Ice Center with Kyoko Ina, John Zimmerman applauding those marks for technical merit and for presentation.
Those are a great set of marks.
They've done everything they can do. One minor error with a hand out of the double axel, but they did a phenomenal performance and they put themselves in the best shape they could to try to sneak on that podium, but they're going to need some help. It's a waiting game now.
They came in fifth place, but they've got a chance.
John Zimmerman had the night of his life tonight. That was fantastic.
And the next pair on the ice has to follow that standing ovation. Maria Petrova and Alexei Tikhonov of Russia. They come in sixth place. What would it be like to take the ice after that?
Well, it's very, very difficult. But the trick is you have to take all that energy in the building and use it for yourself. You know the audience can be behind a great performance, so you have to just take it over.
First Olympics for Petrova and Tikhonov, the 2000 world champions.
Way to start the program, get the ice under your feet.
Another set of side-by-side triple jumps.
A little forward on the landing. Russian pair skating is very well documented. When you look at their top teams, take their top 10, they could send any three and they'd be competitive with anyone in the world, it seems. But sometimes you sense they're kind of cookie cutter. One looks like the next, which looks like the next, and it's hard to get inspired sometimes by their skating. Throw triple toe there, again, very well done.
It's a clean program, but it's passionless.
One thing that's always mentioned is the Russians' dedication to training. I mean, it really is a serious business for them. Russian coaches relocate to the United States now, and I think sometimes they're a little frustrated with their American pupils who don't seem to want to work quite as hard. Petrova and Alexei Tikhonov of Russia. Let's go to Beth Ruyak now with the American team, Ina and Zimmerman. Beth?
All right, thanks, Tom. The only word they keep saying down here is wow and wow. Tell me about it out there, Kyoko.
It was so exciting just to be out there and hearing the USA chants, and they cheered and clapped through everything we did, and it just helped us so much.
John, at the end, you looked at her and said something. What was it that you told her?
I thanked her for being with me and for letting me be with her partner. It's just, I had the greatest time out there with her, and I think it was just the best.
You told me today, it's my house. I got to invite them in, and that crowd told you back. You were doing it.
I'm glad we were a great host tonight. It felt wonderful, and I hope everyone keeps coming back to see us skate. It was just so much fun.
Okay. 2006? What do you think?
I was trying to think about 2002 first.
Yeah, I'm going to enjoy 2002 first. Yeah, it's great.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks
so much.
Thank you.
John.
Thank
All right, back to you, Tom.
Meanwhile, Jamie Salle, David Pelletier of Canada, hoping to win gold before the night is over. They'll skate in about a half hour from now in the final group and playing a little tag. And the Chinese are also backstage. Shen and Zhao trying to make history with a quad throw tonight. They'll be the last ones to skate in that final group.
It's going to be interesting to see if they make the decision to do that quad, because if they land it, it could disrupt the entire routine, and if they miss it, it could disrupt the entire routine. So why put a high-risk element in when you're trying to win a medal? It'll be really interesting to see if they decide to do it.
And here are the marks for Petrova and Tikhonov.
Mama, Papa, we tried.
Technical merit marks.
As we said, it was a clean performance, but it was also slow, a little labored at the end, and a little flat.
And these presentation marks.
Well, they got the Russian judge, but I think the United States judge gave their highest marks to Kyoko and John, so it's kind of a trade-off.
Ina and Zimmerman still alive for a possible medal, and hoping for a gold medal, the Canadian pairs team. Jamie Salle, David Pelletier from opposite ends of Canada. Pelletier from Quebec and Western Canada. Salle, they're hoping to win gold later tonight. Jamie Salle of Canada just had a collision during the warm-up here for this final group to skate. She just collided and was knocked to the ice. Here it is on tape.
Elena and Anton just skating full speed, preparing to come around the corner, and there she was, going in completely the opposite direction.
She was setting up a triple toe loop and was turned with her back to them and turned around, and it just happened.
And they had their back to her just until they stepped forward. See, there, he's looking away.
So was Jamie, and then it was too late.
And then,
Jamie was totally stunned, stayed there for a few moments, but they're both okay.
All four of them are going to be shaken.
She has a little time to collect herself. They're the third pair to skate in this free skate to decide the medals, and they're in second place. The fourth place skaters are up first. Tatiana Totmianina and Maxim Marinin of Russia, the reigning European champions. First Olympics.
Difficult program. Both single skaters are converted to pair skaters. Opening. Triple Sal, a little shaky, but they did it. The first element of the program is always the toughest. The adrenaline is just flowing. You got to calm down and just feel the ice.
Under-rotated.
This is one of the pairs that Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman must finish in front of to win a medal. A report from Beth Ruyak backstage. that Jamie Salé and Anton Sikharulidze all saying that apparently they're okay after that collision in the warm-up.
Combination, side-by-side triple toes. Just a little tilt to put the hand down into double toe.
This pair could actually be the most affected by that collision because they have not had any time to regroup. When something like that happens in a warm-up, everybody is rattled.
Even if you're not involved.
Absolutely,
correctly.
Because it breaks your train of thought.
Zimmerman skated one of the best programs of their lives, and this is one of the pairs that they are competing with for the bronze medal. How do they compare so far? They're just entering the free skate.
It's been a slow performance with lots of little mistakes. She's touched down a couple of times. It's not looking good for them.
This pair was fourth coming to the free skate. Ina and Zimmerman were fifth. And skated an excellent program.
Throw triple sow. And just a little forward on the landing. Maxim, not a big fan of altitude. He's struggled with it in the past. Program is building towards an end and really getting the crowd on your side. Ina and Zimmerman did that. Tatiana and Maxim are going to have to pull something pretty quick to get this crowd going to try to influence the judges.
I think it's a little late for that, Scott. They don't have any steam left at all.
Ina and Zimmerman watching, Totmianina and Marinin, they have a vested interest. They're still alive for a possible medal. And these two look exhausted. Meanwhile, Jamie Salé trying to clear the cobwebs after a warm-up collision. The top three skaters next when we return. Lake Ice Center, Totmianina and Marinin. Awaiting their marks, 5-7 from the French judge.
Those are pretty generous. That performance is nowhere near as commanding as they are in practice.
And there are the placements ranging from first to fourth, but look at that, rank one. And that
unfortunate.
I totally disagree with that.
That ends the medal chances of Ina and Zimmerman. Now to decide the gold, silver, and bronze, Elena Berezhnaya, 1996, she was near death, struck in the head during practice by a skate blade and sent to emergency brain surgery. They had to open her skull. It left her partially paralyzed on her right side, speech impaired, and for a time, her life was in jeopardy. But 2 years later, 1998, with her new partner, Anton Sikharulidze, who had come to her bedside and taken her home, they skated in Nagano and were one lift away from winning gold. They settled for the silver. And now 4 years later,
This couple is exquisite, but they have never skated a clean competition, and they will need to now. This program is gorgeous and difficult. The key elements are the side-by-side jumps and the two throws.
We won't say much during the performance.
So by Anton, this element becomes crucial to their chances of winning the gold medal, this throw triple loop.
She's hanging on to all those throws.
Thank you.
And there weren't many smiles during the performance, but now they seem pleased. They had problems.
It was a bit of a nail biter. I mean, a few of those throws, she hung on to everything. She did everything she could to fight for everything in that performance. I just felt like Anton wasn't over his feet like I've seen him in the past. Normally he's one
of the They both ice. Had to really work for it the whole time. It was not skated with ease as they have in practice.
A bit forced, a bit tight, and a bit slower than I'm used to seeing them skate. Normally this is textbook pair skating. They're still, with that, there won't be anyone close so far in the evening.
And here's what set that tense tone of the entire program. He was leaning outside the circle and out of control, and that is not like Anton.
Just took off the heel a little bit, was a little backward in the air. And then I think I sensed Elena the rest of the time thinking, okay, now it's up to me to hold this thing together. I gotta land everything a little stiffer in the knee in the landings than I'm used to seeing. A nice soft knee with a lot of flow action. A little rigid in the landings, but again, she fought for that one.
And skating next, their pursuers, Jamie Salle, David Pelletier of Canada. She crashed with Anton in the warm-up, but gave us the thumbs up backstage as she's okay.
That's right, and they also know by the audience reaction that Yelena and Anton have not skated their very, very best.
The collision occurred when she was setting up a final pass at a triple toe loop, which they were really kind of iffy on in the warm-up, so it'll be interesting to see if that last pass might have made a difference.
So Anton's reaction to the replay is shown on the big board. And for technical merit, here are the marks. The Russian domination, the last 10 Olympic Games.
Lots of room, lots of room. 5.7s are not normally gold medal winning marks. There's lots of room there, and they know it. She knows
she
it.
She knows it. Wow.
Mostly 5.9s.
The program is the most difficult because the choreography weaves all the tricks in and out, and that was given credit. But these two, Jamie and David, are hungry.
They know it too. They know they've got it. If they just skate clean, that's not the girl that got off the ice. That's the girl that just heard 5.7 on the first mark.
Consider this, 4 years ago, David was selling beer at hockey games in Montreal. Jamie was serving coffee at the Second Cup in Edmonton.
And now they're skating a classic performance, classic choreography, love story. Their key elements are the side-by-side jumps. They open with the side-by-side triple toes. Those are the ones to watch.
Thank you.
Triple loop, and the gold is theirs.
Well, the crowd has made its choice, the standing ovation.
Simply perfect.
And you got a sense that really the program was just an exercise. They knew when they heard 5-7 that this was in their hands.
But they still had to do it. They still had to face their demons and do it, and they did it.
Well, they skated the love story, and they've had their own personal love story. A little rocky at times, maybe.
The hardest thing to do is stay in the moment in a performance, one step at a time. They could taste it for 4.5 minutes.
And all this after a scary collision in the warm-up. How do you compose yourself?
I think that disrupted everything. It kind of put her out of that mode. I sensed a tenseness when they stepped on the ice for warm-up. I sensed fear when she got hit. And then the second they heard that 5-7, they knew it was theirs. It just, everything just went away. Do we like Salt Lake? The ice was good to me, so I'm gonna be good to the ice. Awesome!
Great job.
There were some giant, huge, high, enormous second marks.
Canada House is going to be jumping tonight.
And the Russian domination, nearly four decades, perhaps ended again by Canadians, the last non-Russian pairs to win a gold medal in 1960 when Dwight Eisenhower was president.
It was brilliant, brilliant skating, brilliant choreography. Tender, playful, accessible.
Six.
And perfect.
Six.
Here are the marks.
They're marks for technical merit.
Prolonging the suspense. And they go up. And they're big.
That's a little closer than I thought it was going to be, though.
5-9, 5-8.
Elena and Anton's program was still harder. Technically, it is a little bit harder. This was better skated. That's why it's only just a little bit ahead. But look at this presentation mark.
Comes down to the second mark. Oh!
The placements.
How did that happen?
Oh, the placements. Look at this.
How did that happen?
No.
They won that program.
5-2s and 4 number 1s.
They won that program. There's not a doubt anyone in the place except for maybe a few judges. Wow. That will be debated forever.
Second place.
Debated forever.
The judges seem befuddled.
Broken
Need
ties.
Need five number ones. They got four.
Broken ties.
This competition is not over yet.
Wow.
Wow. And
Xue Shen
and Hongbo are listening to all of this, and they still have to skate.
Now, we've seen it so many times where ordinal shift and the last skater, this new 1v1 system could come into play here. I don't know. Anything can happen still. It's not over.
Shen Xue and Zhao Hongbo from China in third place coming in and attempting to make Olympic history with a quad throw, quad salchow.
Debating whether to attempt this or not. The quad throw salchow, it's never been done before. And the question was to make history or win a medal. Their coach says they're going to do it.
This is enormous.
Here it is.
Yeah! She had it for 4 feet! Oh. It's still ice.
Oh. She's fine. He's the one who hasn't recovered.
Music, by the way, Puccini's Turandot, the opera set in China.
They've spent a lot of time just trying to eliminate their weaknesses, and one of the greatest weaknesses was artistry, presentation.
What I'm amazed with is the fact that they have kept their composure after that quad, because we felt that they were risking the entire program, whether they landed the quad or not, simply because of all the mental attention it would take. But they've kept it together.
You have to ask yourself, if they had landed the quad, what would the judges have done?
Based on earlier results, we have no idea. Well, maybe Sally in tears backstage after they captured the hearts of the crowd. After it appeared to be a foregone conclusion they would win the gold medal.
How do you win the performance, win the night, win the crowd, and lose the medal?
Competition.
Unbelievable.
We'll have the marks for Shen Chue and Zhao Hongbo and the final medal results when we return to the Salt Lake Ice Center.
You did it. You did it.
Welcome back to the Salt Lake Ice Center. Technical merit marks for the Chinese, Shen and Zhao. And the presentation marks.
They have to be pleased with those technical marks and these presentation marks, because that is a nod of approval for their artistry.
Personal victory,
yes,
absolutely a personal victory. And that will give them the bronze medal.
And that quad attempt was phenomenal, Scott.
Oh, they had it.
They had it.
They had it.
So a bronze medal performance for the Chinese, Shen and Zhao. And nearly made history with the quad throw. So close. One had never been landed before in the Olympics.
This pair event will be debated forever. Forever. Berezhnaya and Sikharulidze are a phenomenal pair. Great talents. Everything these judges want in a pair team, but they were not flawless tonight.
But they didn't do it. You have to do it. They made four errors.
So the controversial final medal standings. Berezhnaya and Sikharulidze of Russia continue the domination.
1 point. Since the breakup of the Soviet Union, except for Kristi Yamaguchi and Tara Lipinski, every single gold medal in those Olympics have gone to Russian republics. Mm-hmm. Every single one.
And in pairs since 1960, the last non-Russian pair to win the gold medal. But they'll talk about this one for a long time. We'll be back.
Ending again, Tom Hammond. Tom.
Thank you, Bob. And there is the gold medalist, Anton Sikharulidze, waiting for his partner and the medal ceremony. The dynasty continues. The Russians have won every pair's gold since 1960. Now, here are the judges' placements, and look at the ones that put the Russians first: Russia, China, France, Poland, and Ukraine. So there you have the judges' placements and who they voted first. And just a few moments ago, Beth Ruyak spoke with a shaken Sally and Pelletier.
Thanks, Tom. I can't believe I'm doing this interview with you. I can't imagine what it's like for you.
Well, we skated our hearts out tonight, and it was an unbelievable performance. I'm very emotional right now. Obviously, with a bad collision on the warm-up, my stomach was hurting a lot. Trying not to think about it and talk about it, but I went out there. That's the first time I've been kind of in a pain or in discomfort, and I went through it strong, and I fought till the end, and we skated absolutely perfect.
David, you kissed the ice at the end.
I love this rink. We've been here four clean programs. I love this ice. That's a perfect moment for us. I can't believe we did it like this. It was amazing.
And Elena, back live now, has come out from the dressing room accepting congratulations from the Chinese. And,
it's funny, because if this is a controversial result, it comes down on Anton and Elena. And all they did was skate the best they had tonight. And honestly, they're a quality pair, a beautiful pair, arguably the best pair in the world. They've just won the Olympic gold medal. If you're upset at anything, be upset with the judges. You have your own opinion, private, but don't point it at them. And I just hope the reaction from the audience isn't negative, because, again, it was a beautiful event. It's a well-fought event. Jamie and David skated their hearts out. They were beautiful. They were perfect. It didn't go their way. Life's like that sometimes.
And
the results are not Elena and Anton's fault, no.
But normally this would be such a feel-good story, because just a lift away from the gold 4 years ago, 2 years before that, she was near death. So it would be so good without the controversy. But you wonder, did they deserve it?
But nobody wants to win this way either.
To know her history, karma. Something wonderful had to happen for her, and this was it.
But this is bittersweet for them.
And you look at them, and you see them, and it's just, they earned it tonight. And it just, it breaks my heart to see this, because as much as you wanted to see both of them skate their best and just leave it in the hands of the judges, there won't be any doubt. You know, there's a mistake here, a mistake here, a mistake there. Elena and Anton weren't at their best tonight, and you just, for the rest of their lives, they got to wonder, what if? I couldn't have done any better. Jamie couldn't have done any better. David couldn't have done any better. Anton and Elena could have. And maybe they are, in the judges' minds, a tenth or two better than everybody else. The program's a little more difficult, sure, but it wasn't flawless.
That's right.
I have no idea. I have no idea.
So 11 Olympic Winter Games in a row.
They just find a way.
This is the first controversial one. This is the first controversial one.
The longest domination in any winter Olympic sports continues.
Wow. What an event.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And now the award ceremony.
Here's competition from now taking place.
Of course, going to be tough to step on that second step, isn't it?
I think it'll be tough for them to step on the top step, too.
Why not as tough? But it's
it was
one of the finest pair events I've ever seen, whether it be an Olympics or Worlds, or it was just beautiful, difficult, athletic, artistic skating.
Shen and Hongbo Zhao.
And they were a toe pick. One little extra toe pick on the bottom of that blade, Quad Sal history.
And this is one placing the judges all agreed on.
And I think we would all agree that the Chinese are about to become a major force in the world of figure skating.
Representing Canada, Jamie Sully and David Pelletier.
And the fans on their feet.
At the end of the day, it's always the process and rarely the result. You're going to look back on this night and know that you did everything you possibly could, and that's all you could do. The process is the key.
Representing the Russian Federation, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikharulidze.
It's so good to get tepid applause announcing the gold medals.
But the audience is still standing for them, and that's nice to see because they do not deserve to be blamed for this. My heart breaks for both pairs, and I'm embarrassed for our sport right now.
Les médailles seront remises par Monsieur Herb.
Nice show. Sportsmanship and fellowship.
accompagné par Madame Joyce Risey, déléguée technique de l'Union internationale de patinage.
The medals will now be presented by Mr. Hu Zhongliang, International Olympic Committee member of the People's Republic of China, accompanied by Mrs. Joyce Risey, International Skating Union technical delegate.
Medals awarded, the bronze to the Chinese, who certainly are happy with their performance. A little tough to smile, maybe, but the crowd helps. And the gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the gold medalist, the Russian Federation.
So the Russian domination of Olympic pair skating continues here in Salt Lake City.
Here they are, ladies and gentlemen, your Salt Lake 2002 Olympic Winter Games pairs bronze, silver, and gold medalists, Xue Shen and Hongbo Zhao, Jamie Soleil and David Pelletier, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Zimmerman. Let's really hear it for them.
So the first figure skating event at these Winter Games featured beautiful skating in the pair's free skate with a controversial finish. The Russians win again, and there's yet another judging controversy in the figure skating world. That's it from the Salt Lake Ice Center.
The Salt Lake City 2002.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes...